hey guys, I'm gonna go to Singapore, and before I go, I'm gonna get some diarrhea medicine, because in Singapore, they don't have pharmacies. Okay, so follow me. Talk, diarrhea,
panic,
like cock, like. Like, ang, no good. Big Bang.
Big Bang.
Big Bang. 21.
21. Big Man.
Big Bang.
Big Bang.
Big Bang.
Big Bang. Big Bang.
Okay, okay. Toy, Biet, Mbiet, Dam Vinh Hung.
Biet.
Dam Vinh Hung.
Biet.
Biet. So I'm just practicing my Vietnamese, guys, on the way to the airport, because, you know, just I've been living here for a while, and, you know, anh ơi, tôi em là YouTube superstar number one.
YouTube
là internet, là phim. Internet phim. Tôi em làm internet phim, em là superstar number one.
Superstar
number one.
So I'm at the airport and I'm ready to depart to Singapore. So my flight is in about an hour and a half, an hour. I'm just gonna go in, check in, and on to the airplane. I wanna say that I'm excited. Yes, even though I'm going on a business trip, you know, I'm going to work, I just still like the sensation of the elevation, just ascending into the air. That's a good sensation. It feels really good. That, and I think for a few hours on the flight, it's an hour and a half for me, but still, for that hour and a half, I get time to myself, time to think about the future, you know? It's a very tranquil experience, and that's why I love traveling. Just waiting for my flight. And what does life in Vietnam mean for OldBoy? Well, I'll tell you what it means for OldBoy. It means freedom. Freedom to do many different things that you weren't able to do back in the States. Like right now, I'm not wearing underwear. Do I miss living in America? Absolutely not. I don't miss commuting all day. I don't miss paying taxes. I don't miss paying car bills and insurance. And top of that, and on top of that, and on top of that, and on top of that. Just the whole daily ritual to the deathbed. I don't miss it at all. So please don't ask me ever again, do you miss living in America? Because I don't miss it, and you!
Make your attention, please. This call
should leave now.
Free. Letting the wind blow, and it's refreshing. The wind is blowing, freeballing it. And it's a very it's a refreshing feeling, guys. It's like a whiff of cold air. So in record time, I got out of immigration in about 10 minutes. 10 minutes. That was pretty good. You know, I rushed it, and I really, really just got out of there. And right now, I'm talking to the Singaporean taxi driver.
No, English. English, I don't know.
How much will this room cost you? About $50, okay? So let's take a quick tour of this Singaporean $50 room. So you have that. And you have a phone. Do you see that? Yeah, a phone. A bed. A small TV on the wall. And then we have a small desk. And then that. Okay, so it's not much, but that's all I need. I'm not here to play, I'm here to work. So this is all I need, a room, a bed, a TV, that's all I need, and cigarettes. So I just woke up in pain, I'm grumpy, but I still have to go to work.
Okay.
Anthony Bourdain eating tulang.
Yeah.
I didn't know there are two places that sells tulang. But I'm gonna try both. Is that okay? But I'm gonna say both are very good. Because I don't want you guys to hurt me. Yeah, that's really hot. I didn't expect it to be that hot, but very hot. It's good. Can I have a straw? Both are very good. Both are immensely good, guys. Okay, I'm not saying one is better than the other. But here I go. Let me try this bread. Yeah, another texture of bread. Let me try this one. Another very iconic Singaporean dish has to be chicken rice. So here I go. So it's been about 40 minutes now since I've been waiting for that chicken rice. That better be a tremendous chicken rice, otherwise I just wasted 40 minutes of my time just sitting here. Here we go. Let's see here. Let's see if this is really that good. Okay, so let's do that. Oh, yeah. Mmm. It's good. It's good. Yeah. No, I've never had chicken rice like this in its authenticity. So I'm gonna dip it in the black sauce, dip it in that. Okay. Now I know why they wait in line for this. Okay. Now the rice. Okay, that's good. Okay. I understand now why they wait like 40 minutes for this chicken rice. Yeah, that is really pretty good. That is damn good. And they're still waiting in line for this chicken rice. That was the best chicken rice I had in my life. I mean, it was really that good. One thing that I've noticed is that the younger generation of Singaporeans, they speak like really good English, and then like the old generation of Singaporeans, like they like mix it up with a little bit of like Mandarin. So a lot of times I'm just like, I'm just clueless about what they're saying. But I know they're speaking English, but it's like a hybrid of a language. But they assume that I can speak a little bit of that Chinese, which is kind of funny because maybe I do look a lot like a Chinese guy. Say, Singapore is different, you know, compared to the other Southeast Asias. You won't find many delinquent English teachers here. You know, you won't find guys who are running away from their problems. You know, this place is too expensive to be running away from your problems. Any last thoughts? Well, I just paid $50 for a Japanese meal, which I think wasn't that all that great. I think I've had better in Vietnam and it only costs $15. So it's a multiple of threes here that I've noticed. Food is very expensive. Vietnam food is very cheap. transportation is cheap here. I think in certain ways cheaper than transportation in Vietnam. You have more shopping that you can do here. I think that Vietnamese girls may be more attractive than the Singaporean girls. I think that this place has a share of vices. It's open. What else? Would I want to live here? Probably not. Probably not. So, right now, I'm on my way back to the hotel, and I'm done. Tomorrow morning, I'm out of here. Those are my last thoughts. And my last thought is subscribe to Kale.net. And my last thought is, you know, I do it for my hood, my original OG fan base, you know? This is who I do it for. All right, subscribe to Kale.net. And I will see you in Vietnam.